At issue is whether the statements published by the media in the fire chief's ongoing row with the Fire Service Association were defamatory. The Fire Service Association, Choice, HTS, and DBS are joined in the defamation suit. The claimant's attorney says he had asked the defendants to provide transcripts of the news broadcast of March 21, 2012, but they failed to cooperate. For his part, the attorney for Choice 39 argued that he received a request for transcripts of a news item carried on September 8, 2010, but was in no position to satisfy the request since Choice Television was not producing news at that time.
It's our case that we are not liable or guilty of the matters that are the accusations that are made against us. And, you know, to a certain extent, the claimant was seeking for us to produce the evidence so that they can then sue us for the, you know, the defamation claim. We did not want to partake in that. But in any event, as it were, we now will ask by the court to produce the transcripts of the day, and that we will do. And we're confident that we will be vindicated.
However, according to the attorney for the claimant, each of the defendants received a letter on April 2, 2012, requesting the transcripts for a news item published on March 21st. The court decided that the first order of business would be to review the transcripts to determine whether they contained defamatory statements. To this end, the court ordered that the transcripts for the day in question be produced within 5 days. As a result, a second hearing for further case management has been scheduled for January 14, 2013. We asked one of the defense attorneys how he fancied his chances in the matter.
The court is certainly concerned that when parties come before it, they are placed on an equal footing. So they want to make sure that you know, each party has its house in order, and it, both in terms of the documents that are filed before it, put before it, and the positions that various counsels are taking.
Okay, how confident are you of coming out victorious in this matter?
Well, we are 100% confident. We're sure that we will be vindicated, and be vindicated at a very early stage.
The claimant's attorney declined to comment on camera but provided oral context to the matter. Many observers are looking closely at this case as they think the outcome of the case will determine the level of media freedom on the island. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.